it's such a popular contest, and all the winners come out a little bit later in the show, but right now we begin with this awful story. A 95-year-old great-grandmother is fighting for life in hospital after she was tasered by police at an aged care home in the New South Wales Snowy Mountains.
Ashley Wick is at Cooma Hospital. Ash, what's the latest?
Well, Sarah, we know last night our great-grandmother, 95-year-old Claire Nowland, was fighting for her life here at Cooma Hospital. Devastated friends and family have been by her bedside here in the Snowy Mountains in southern New South Wales after the 95-year-old was tasered by police. Ms Nowland suffers dementia. She lives in an aged care facility not far from here, and it is there where she was tasered by police on Wednesday afternoon. It's understood that Ms Nowland was standing near her walker holding a kitchen knife when worried staff called police. Now, the force of that taser caused Ms Nowland to fall onto the ground and suffer critical injuries. New South Wales Police says it has launched a critical investigation into the incident to determine exactly how and why this has occurred.
All right, Ash, thank you.
A man has been arrested and charged with arson after a deadly hostel fire left 6 dead in New Zealand. Wellington police confirmed several more serious charges are pending. His identity hasn't been revealed, but local media is reporting the man was a resident of the building. 2 of the 6 bodies have now been removed from the crime scene at Loafers Lodge. A 16-year-old boy has been stabbed in front of horrified commuters outside a train station in Melbourne's west. It's believed the teenager was on his way home before he was chased and attacked at the Sunshine Station bus interchange.
So the attacker was the one that was screaming, and he had a black hoodie on, and he was the one that was running from literally over here all the way down to where the scene actually happened.
No arrests have been made at this stage. A teenager has been charged this morning after 3 children were struck by a car at a pedestrian crossing in Sydney's north. 3 boys aged between 12 and 13 were treated by paramedics at Crow's Nest for serious leg and head injuries. The 18-year-old driver is due to face court later today. Murder charges have now been laid after a mother of 4 was stabbed to death in Queensland. Heather Ball died on the footpath outside her Caboolture unit, allegedly stabbed by a man known to her. Police say he fled the scene with a pursuit ending when he crashed into a police van. He'll face court today, and if you or anyone you know is a victim of domestic violence, you can call 1-800-RESPECT. That's 1-800-737-732.
The AFL is in shock this morning after Alastair Clarkson confirmed he's stepping down as North Melbourne coach. He says he needs time away from the game to focus on his mental and physical well-being. He's been under pressure for months over a racism inquiry at his former club, Hawthorn. Let's bring in Today Melbourne reporter Christina Hearn with more on this. Chris, good morning. What does this mean for the Hawthorn racism investigation?
Well, Sarah, it's in chaos. I mean, it's clear there needs to be some kind of conclusion to the racism investigation, and soon, after the Kangaroos coach, Alastair Clarkson, announced that he was stepping away from the game indefinitely as he seeks help for his mental health. There are mediation talks planned next Tuesday in Adelaide with the First Nations players, but that now it's unlikely that Alastair Clarkson will be attending that. The 8-month investigation, according to the ruse, leaving Clarkson only able to sleep for about 2 hours a night, and there are reports on the weekend that he threw a chair across the change room during that weekend's match. Of course, certainly the cracks started to appear last week when Clarkson labelled the conduct of his former club Hawthorn as shameful and the investigation process a circus, all that culminating in his decision to walk away.
You got a good feel for the animosity he's got towards the Hawthorn Football Club, and such serious allegations to be had and have no reply. It's been enormously hurtful to him.
The club is standing by Alastair Clarkson. Of course, it was only last year he was unveiled as the saviour here at the Kangaroos, signed for 5 years on a multi-million dollar deal. They're now languishing in 16th place. Brett Ratton will take the reins till Clarkson returns, whenever that will be. Sarah.
What a saga. Chris, thank you.
Economists are predicting interest rate rises will go on hold for now after a surprise move in the unemployment rate. Figures for April show an extra 18,000 Australians were left without work, increasing the official jobless rate to 3.7%. It's the latest sign the economy is slowing as the Reserve Bank tries to fight high inflation with rate hikes. It seems the trade war between Australia and China is thawing with our timber exports to resume. China's ambassador to Australia also announced President Xi Jinping's office is working on setting a date for Anthony Albanese to visit Beijing. Two bodies have been found in the search for survivors of a Chinese fishing boat after it capsized in the Indian Ocean. That's according to Chinese state media, which couldn't provide details on the nationalities of the victims. The driver of a bus carrying 45 children caught up in a horror crash outside of Melbourne is being praised for his efforts to save his passengers. Police say Graham Stanley may have prevented further disaster by accelerating after noticing the truck was about to hit them. Graham has since returned home wearing a moon boot for a fractured ankle.
He wants to get back into it. We all understand that he has some things to get through that'll take time. Put so many others, particularly the students, ahead of his own well-being and safety.
Nine patients remain across two hospitals in a stable condition, recovering from life-changing injuries. A manhunt is underway in Adelaide this morning for a thief who stole a car with a baby in the back seat. Fortunately, the little boy was found safe when he and has been reunited with his parents. Emily McDonald has the story.
These are the moments before an everyday errand turns into a nightmare. A mother picking something up from a pet store notices something strange. Her parked car is beginning to move with her little boy strapped in the back seat. She races outside to stop the thief, yanking open the back door. But the car takes off, leaving the mother injured on the road.
She went running out and her car was rolling back and someone stole the car with the baby in the car. She fought hard. She tried to grab the guy.
Just yelling like, oh, they got my baby. Baby's in the bag.
Security vision captures the car fleeing the scene as a full-scale search is launched. But after 20 minutes, the Mazda SUV was dumped and 16-month-old Ali was found safe, his dad rushing to the scene while his mum received treatment in hospital.
It's traumatic for the lady especially and the father of the child and everything, and just for someone to be so brazen to do it in, you know, daylight.
Pubs and clubs across New South Wales are set to see all external pokies-related signage removed under a new gaming law crackdown. Venues which display phrases like VIP lounge and images of dragons, coins and certain motifs will face up to $11,000 in fines over each offence. The signage ban will come into effect from the 1st of September. Two cold fronts are approaching Sydney, promising to bring near record-breaking low temperatures. Chilly and windy conditions will worsen in the coming days, with some areas to shiver through the lowest May temperatures since 1999. A young dad who risked his life to try to save others during Dreamworld's deadly ride malfunction 7 years ago will today receive one of our highest bravery rewards. Steve Apthorpe was on the Thunder River Rapids ride when the raft behind him upended with six people on board. For his actions, he will receive the Bronze Medal for bravery from the Royal Humane Society of Australasia in Brisbane. Prime Minister Anthony Albanese has led tributes to our national treasure, Yunupingu, at a memorial in remote Arnhem land. And a warning for our First Nations viewers, this story contains images of a deceased person. Mr Albanese joined family, friends and community leaders at the service, delivering what he called a eulogy for a giant.
He had every right to be cynical, but he wasn't. No matter how often Australia let him down, he kept striving to have us rise to his level of integrity.
The 1978 Australian of the Year died last month, aged 74. Let's get a look at the markets for you now. On Wall Street, the Dow Jones is down and the S&P 500 is faring better. At home, the All Ords closed up yesterday. In London, the FTSE also ended in the green. Commodities and gold is at $1,900 US dollars an ounce and oil is at $76 US dollars a barrel.